Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Exigence Educator. I am Dipanjan Pal, your English educator. Okay, so on our last class, we have discussed the new type of spotting error, where there were a large sentence and you need to find out whether there are four errors or three errors, more than one errors, and the options were in a very new pattern also. Today we are going to discuss our class based on advanced level multiple fillers, where the sentence is a very large sentence where you need to fill up more than one blanks. Okay, so today we have a set of six questions and we will discuss thoroughly like we did before. Okay, so the first questions we have, that the direction is, in each of the following sentences there are four blank spaces. Five pairs of words are given below each sentence. Find out which pair of words can be filled up in the blanks in the sentence in the same sequence to make it meaningfully complete. I mean, hope it is totally understandable to you that what is the directions, that this is the whole sentence and you just need to put the appropriate words among these options and make the sentence grammatically and contextually correct. Okay, so let's start with the first sentence. The worst market sell-off in Dash history. What will be the approach of doing this kind of sentences? So here are five options are there, A, B, C, D, E. And for the first blanks, you have recent, just only current is there. Just so you have to remind of these options, that current. Okay. Now, what's the basic difference between recent and current? Recent means it is having happened. It is having happened a short while ago. A short while ago. Okay. Whereas current means it is occurring at the moment. So in case of first blank, you have got only one exception, that is current. Okay, so let's proceed. So it may be recent, may be current, history may be around the corner. Okay, so how could you say that it's current history? So obviously it is recent history. So recent is fixed but current is there, so option B will be automatically eliminated from your choice. Just don't blame China alone for it. Since 2007, the aggregate size of central bank's balance sheets has tripled. It's a clue word or it's a positive sign. Has tripled to $22 trillion dash by, and next year is blotted compress, blotted, blotted. So has triple, it's a positive sign. It's a graph of increasing, only increasing. But compressed means squeezing. So it doesn't match with the meaning of the sentence. So option C is eliminated, although it was started with recent. So got it. How am I eliminating the options? So the sentence is doable with the rest of the options A, D, and E. So blotted could be the options, because blotted means inflated. Blotted means inflated. Okay. So recent and blotted. So option A, D, E, all of these are same. So we have to proceed. After Lehman Brothers collapse. Now collapse is your clue word. If it is suggesting collapse, then how could you say that it is influenced by? So this is a very positive word, whereas collapse is a negative approach. So option C is eliminated. So you have only two options left, A and E. Now the point is, in case of option A as well as E, the first three options are same: recent, blotted, and triggered. So obviously you could say it's triggered, because triggered a route. Okay, so route means what? We can say route means stampede. Route means stampede. So you can trigger high up. You can trigger a route. The biggest central bank around the world dash quantitative easing, or huge words of cheap money to encourage investment and bolster confidence. So around the world dash quantitative easing. How could you say enlarge quantitative easing? Because it doesn't match with the sentence again. It will be unleash, because unleash means let off or abandon. So option A will be your correct answer. And as there is enlarge, it's a clue word. That is why option E is also eliminated. So I am completing the sentence with the suitable words. That is, and one more thing, maybe I have left that bolster. This bolster means boost. Bolster, it means it is boosting your confidence. So what could be the whole sentence? The worst market sell-off in recent history may be around the corner, full stop. Just don't blame China alone for it, full stop. Since 2007, the aggregate size of central bank's balance sheet has tripled to $22 trillion, blotted by asset repurchases to stave off a deeper crisis, full stop. After Lehman Brothers collapse triggered a route stampede, the biggest central banks around the world unleashed quantitative easing. That means it is called, I have said, let off. Quantitative easing or huge words of cheap money, comma, to encourage investment and bolster confidence. Bolster means boost. Here, the comprehension of sentence is needed, as well as I must want to give you the advice that you should learn the elimination of the options. That, like I did a couple of minutes ago, that with viewing to this meaning, I can easily eliminate these options. Like I have eliminated recent and current. With the meaning of the sentence, I have eliminated compressed. And like this way, I have eliminated influenced by and enlarged. So elimination is also a process to make a sentence correct by choosing the options. Okay. Moving on to the next slide, which is question number 2. The target to achieve full and productive employment and decent work for all women and men appears admirable. Admirable, it means glorious. Admirable, it means glorious. But making zero unemployment a global policy is foolish. Absolutely true. Every economy needs some unemployment dash. So first gap is here. Every economy needs some unemployment. So every economy is the subject here, and every economy needs some employment. This person is in active voice. This person is in active voice. So all these are in active, but option A is passive, to be allowed. So A will be automatically eliminated. You don't need to proceed the options anymore. Okay. So to allow is the correct approach, as the sentence is in active voice. Okay. But in case of B, C, D, and E, all these options are filled up with the same option, which is to allow. It may confuse you. So you don't need to stop here. Rather, you need to read or go through the sentence carefully. So every economy needs some unemployment to allow workers to change jobs. Okay, it's correct. All governments are already focused. All governments are already focused. Now, these are in sense of passive. These are in sense of passive, that all governments, be verb plus V3, are focused. And we often see this, that focus is generally followed by on, the preposition. And here, on is available on A, B, and C, D, and E also. So A has already been eliminated. So we need to focus where we are getting on. And it is available in B, in D, and E also. And as we say on, it's a preposition. We need a noun there. And that is why we need getting. It's a gerund. Okay. So we are not sure whether option B or D or E will be the correct options. Okay. Maybe there is some technical issue at the time of preparing the presentations because the rest of the options are not given. So we have eliminated options E also. Okay, so B and D are left. So on getting more workers to change jobs, unemployment to allow workers to change job, all governments are already focused on getting more people into work. Absolutely correct till now. Moreover, studies show such language is used by interest groups to create great jobs for a minority while leaving others out in the cold. Here, out in the cold, it's a phrase. It means when someone is ignored or neglected. Out in the cold means ignored or neglected. Often pushing qualified workers. It doesn't make any sense. So D is also eliminated. So option B is only left, and it must be the correct choice. But we should proceed. Out in the cold, often pushing vulnerable workers. It's a very good word, vulnerable. It means penetrable. P-E-N-E-T-R-A-B-L-E. It means penetrable workers back into the informal economy and increasing poverty. The cost of this target will likely outweigh the benefits. Likely outweigh. It means the greatness, the seriousness. Okay. So what is the actual answer? The target to achieve full and productive employment and decent work for all women and men appears admirable. But making zero unemployment a global policy is foolish. Every economy needs some unemployment to allow workers to change jobs. All governments are already focused on getting more people into work, a sense of jiran. Moreover, studies show such language is used by interest groups to create great jobs for a minority while leaving others out in the cold, while leaving others ignored or neglected. Often pushing vulnerable workers back into the informal economy and increasing poverty. Full stop. The cost will this target will likely outweigh the benefits. That means it will obviously have the greatness, the seriousness of getting the benefits. I hope it's absolutely understandable to you. Move on to the third question. Third, take achieving DASH access to contraception and family planning. It will mean DASH options, orphans and mothers dying in childbirth. Take achieving global access. We can't say global access in this particular case. You can say global warming, but you can't say global access. It is called universal. So from the very first line or the very first sense of these sentences, we have eliminated options A. And rest, there are four options, B, C, D, and E. So keeping in mind that first fill in the blanks should be filled with universal. Okay. universal. So take achieving universal access to contraceptions. Contraceptions, probably you all know about that, that it's the only way of having safe sex. Okay, contraception and family planning, it will mean dash options and mothers dying in childbirth. Look, there is the clue to contraception and family planning. So these are the two things which indicates some positive indication. And positive indication means when you are making actually a case of dying or reading the case of dying, that means it is decreasing. So how could you say more? So option B is eliminated. So C, D and E are left. I mean, taking the accessibility of contraception and by making family planning, we are reducing the dying of childbirth. So how could you say more? It is talking about the decreasement. So the next option will be fewer. Okay. And as it is countable, we successfully are using fewer. We are successfully using fewer. So it will also generate a demographic dividend. Obviously, demographic profit doesn't make any sense. It's also a wrong concept. So you can see that as you are going through the sentence very carefully, the concept of the sentence itself helps you to eliminate a particular word, and by eliminating a particular word, you are often able to eliminate the whole options, and that is what we are doing. So now we can say that we have only two options left, option C and option E. And in case of both these options, first three words are same. And obviously, it will be demographic dividend. Dividend with ending tuberculosis by 2030, saving nearly 1.5 million lives a year, with each dollar leading to $43 worth of benefits, and completing the Doha Free Trade Deal, lifting incomes and cutting poverty, especially in developing countries, the benefits would be worth $2,000 more than the cost. Okay. So I am just repeating the sentence, take achieving universal access to contraception and family planning, it will mean universal orphans and mothers dying in childbirth, full stop. It will also generate, it will mean fewer orphans and mothers dying in childbirth. Okay, it will also generate a demographic dividend with more people of productive age. Full stop. In total, every dollar spent will mean $120 of benefits to society. Full stop. Probably I missed it. Full stop. Comma dash. Likewise, that means the process, the method we did in case of ending the tuberculosis, how could you say unlike? Unlike means there is some dissimilarity, but likewise means alike, or you can say besides, a s should be added with it. Besides ending tuberculosis, we are also successfully doing this in addition to. So likewise is the correct choice. We cannot say unlike. Unlike is absolutely opposite to that. So option C will be the correct answer, and it will be likewise. Clear? Moving on to the next questions, which is number 4. Analysis of all the benefits and cost shows. Why shows? Because analysis is the subject, and singular subject means you need singular verb. So shows is correct here. That focusing on the top 19 targets - Copenhagen consensus centers would achieve 4 times more than if we spread all the development spending around 169 targets. Again, I'm saying analysis of all the benefits or cost shows that focusing on the top 19 targets, obviously past participle will be there, identified by. But interestingly, all these options are same, at least the first option. So identified by, so you cannot assume what will be your correct answer by filling up just the first options. Okay, so identified by the Copenhagen Consensus Center would achieve 4 times more than if we spread all the development spending around 169 targets. Full stop. In other words, - very carefully. In other words, comma, that means in this filling the blanks, a subject is needed. A subject is needed, and the subject is none but a noun. And we know that we have a special noun or special form of noun that is called jira. Now, prioritizing is the correct option, but prior to it doesn't make any sense here. And to plus would, it is also making a wrong sense. So options B has eliminated. So in other words, prioritizing, it's a chiran, would have the same effect as quadrupling the entire budget. Quadrupling means it's just multiply by 4 the entire budget. Even here on the floor of the United Nations, I find that global leaders, ambassadors, and those who work in development agree that the targets, it should be passive, that the targets should have been, you say the letter has written or the letter has been written. So the targets should have been severally pruned, and pruned means trimmed. Pruned means trimmed. So here will be a concept of should have been. So should have been is not available in C, eliminated. So option A, B, and E are still available. Should have been severally pruned, I mean trimmed. They just all want their targets, full stop. But dash off, here you can say instead of, but here it is along. Along is presented with. So option E will be the, option E will be eliminated. Okay, so option A and D are left. Here is also instead, here is also instead. But look at this, maybe I have also not noticed. I haven't noticed that it is identify by. But here we need identified by. So option D will be the correct answer, because the preposition itself gives you the idea that it should be followed by instead, not along. We generally say along with. Okay, so the answer will be analysis of all the benefits and cost shows that focusing on the top 19 targets identified by the Copenhagen Census Center would achieve 4 times more than if we spread all the development spending around 169 targets. In other words, prioritizing would have the same effect as quadrupling the entire budget. Even here on the floor of the United Nations, I find that global leaders, ambassadors, and those who work in development agree that the targets should have been severally pruned. They just all want their targets. But instead of making this a game of who got the most of their targets into the final declaration, it should be all about getting the most effective targets in India. I hope it's totally understandable to you. I must say the sentence is very long and the options are very confusing. Like, I haven't noticed actually that the option is filled up with identify. So this gives me a bit of confusion that how could both the options are same, could be the same. So after that, I noticed that it is identify by, and the option D is filled up with identified by. So you have to be also careful about the options. So I hope there is no queries between question number 1 to question number 4. Move on to the next slide, which is question number 5. Will they succeed? It's an interrogative. No harm trying. No harm trying. That means there will be no loss. Does India weaken its case by aligning with the G4? Nonsense. China's argument that it would support India dash where to break ranks with Japan and US agreement, that it has no problem with India's candidature but remains conflicted on Germany over Italy and Brazil over Mexico, are all divide and rule dash and have to be exposed as such. Okay, so one by one, will this succeed? No harm trying, there is no loss. Does India weaken its case by allying with the G4? Nonsense. China's argument that it should support India, it would support India, it makes a condition, it makes a condition or stipulation that if that is wrong, so option A is eliminated. As India, it is replaced with a pronoun it. So B, C, D, and E are left. So if it were to break, as it's a still a condition which has not fulfilled but wished to be fulfilled, that is why the helping verb is presented with where. Like we say, if I were Shah Jahan, I would die for Mumtaz, in that sense. So it should support if it were to break ranks with Japan and the US argument that it has no problem with India's candidature, that means candidate, but remains conflicted on Germany, over Italy and Brazil, over Mexico, and all divide and rule is tactics. It's not a plan is a specific thing, but tactics means this is your policy. So B has been eliminated. So all divide and rule tactics and have to be exposed as such. None of the P5 countries, none, and it is the subject, and none is generally used as singular category, so it will be has given. So C is eliminated because it is written in passive, whereas the sentence is written in active format. So B and E are left. Tactics and have to be exposed as such. None of the P5 countries has given cast iron guarantees to India that it would get India into the UNSC if it abandons the G4, abandons, cancel, reject. So the argument that the G4 route weakens India's case is a red herring. So option E will be the correct option. Red herring and red tape, these are the two different. The option is, correct option is E, but what's the difference? Look, red tape doesn't make any sense here because red tape means excessive adherence to official rules. Or rigid adherence to official rules. But if you say red herring actually means bluff, or you can say a clue which is intended to be misleading. So if you read the last line, none of the P5 countries has given cast iron guarantees to India that it would get India into the UNSC if it abandons the Z4. Obviously, this abandonment gives you the clue that whether it's a bluff or it's a clue to the mislead. So the argument that the G4 route weakens India's case is a red herring. So how could you say India's case is a red tape, where red tape actually means an excessive adherence to official rules? Okay. So in this way, we are actually eliminating the options, and at the end, we are choosing the correct options. Move on to the next questions, which is our last questions for today. Question number 6. On each part, China created the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO, to pursue, not to argue, to pursue. So option B has also eliminated in the first line, to pursue its geopolitical and geoeconomic interest in Eurasia. So the first option is to pursue its geopolitical and geoeconomic interest in Eurasia. The US has not. The US, it's the subject. So again, it should be in active, not in passive. But C is in passive. Eliminate option C. So now A, D, and E. So the US has not hesitated to create mega regional trade groups. The Trans-Pacific Partnership and the Trans-Atlantic Trade and Investment Partnership to deal with the Chinese trade threat. Diplomats and analysts will debate forever on the usefulness. Useful is an adjective, but we need a noun. So D is eliminated. So diplomats and analysts will debate forever on the usefulness. Has not hesitated. And it will be usefulness. Usefulness of this and other such associations, groups, alliance, and partnerships. Some succeed in their objectives. Many fail, full stop. Many fail. Here it's ended with a full stop. Dash, comma, that means contrasting, create a contrast. Yet more are getting created. So options A will be the correct option. If you say indeed means that's really, that's not yet, instead of more are getting created. So option E is also eliminated and A is the final answer. I'm just repeating. On its port, China created the Shanghai Cooperation Organization to pursue its geopolitical and geoeconomic interest in Eurasia. The US has not hesitated to create mega regional trade groups. Probably it's an error. Create will be there. Create mega regional trade groups, the Trans-Pacific Partnership and the Transatlantic Trade and Investment Partnership to deal with the Chinese trade. Full stop. Diplomats an analyst will debate forever on the usefulness of this and other such associations, groups, alliance, and partnerships. Full stop. Some succeed in their objectives, comma, many fail, full stop. Yet it's contrast. Yet more are getting created. So obviously the last sentence is absolutely creating a contrast, and that is why we are not ending the session with indeed. Rather, we chose yet. Okay. So we have discussed a set of 6 questions where advanced level of multiple fillers have been discussed, and I hope it is totally clear to you and you like all those questions, whatever I have discussed today. Still, if you have any queries, you can send an email at exigenceeducator@gmail.com. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching the class. Have a nice day.